Pearson across from the one. Larry Pearson returned the punt to the guy three. Leonard, Don Moorhead put over. Ben Gillian's 25-yard field goal made it 24-12. Woody Hayes simply said, all good things must come to an end. In the other locker room, the Wolverines were raising the roof. The ship heckling era had begun. Perhaps the only thing sweeter than victory itself is victory against the odds.
The Stadium Theater Game Day Presentation. coming.
Yeah. That's a thing of George Gipper.
Uh-huh. I'm filming everything. Looking at the rest of this timeline thing here first.
We're gonna go to the other side, okay?
Okay.
Thank you.
The Stadium Theater game day presentation will begin in 2 minutes.
See, when you're dealing with a player's pride. That's the most valuable thing he has and the thing that he can help you the most with as a coach. If you've got pride, boy, it's hard to beat a guy with pride.
It takes a little mean student body to defeat a great football player.
Sorry.
When you come up, be right in here. The kind of thing that will punish you at times when you should go to bed and get your rest, and it says you can't go to bed. You got to read and find the solution.
I think you can learn discipline. I think you can learn that you can push a little bit harder than you thought you could. If a guy quits when he gets tired, he'll quit later in life when he gets tired. You'll always go more than you think you can. I think football pushes an individual just as far as that individual wants to go. And the more he pushes and the more he advances, the more pleasure he receives from the game. I think there's some carryover value for that after you get out of school.
I think it teaches to the player that the team is more important than the individual. And I think that's a pretty good lesson for all of us. Kennedy once said, our quest for freedom is choking us today. I think it is.
For those that it's meant for, it is a great, great game. Run within the rules and run properly. It has its place flat on that campus and the educational system.
There's no better feeling to come off the field than when you won and you kind of think, gosh, we just outwitted these guys. Coming off the road to the field, number one, is something else. But I'll tell you, strange thing about it, on Tuesday, you get a month in that field. Fame is fleeting, victory is kind of fleeting. If I could say the thing that I was more proud of was the end result of the players who played.
They are our most precious possession. What you give to another person, and it helps them and he can pass it on. It lives forever. Everything you keep to yourself, you go, it is gone. I actually don't believe you can be a good coach unless you learn.
I think that all coaches will say to you, the association I've had with the players was the best thing about the whole thing. Because the success you had could be varied according to the ability of the players. But the feeling for the players will remain for a lifetime.
There's a certain mystique about a football locker room. Maybe it's because few people besides players and coaches ever go there. Maybe it's because of famous locker room speeches, or the notion that this is the place where coaches breathe fire into their players. Ultimately, the locker room is the inner sanctum of college football. But preparation for the game, coaching, begins long before the locker room and reaches far beyond the field of play.
I like quiet confidence. do you think we're going to do that, Charlie? We're going to beat him, coach. We're going to beat him.
It's an old thing. I don't know where I got the idea, but it was from somebody. Go look in the mirrors before you go out. Now look at it when you come in. Just if you say one thing, I play as hard as I can play, we're going to be all right. The role of a college football coach, of course, is the obvious. He has to know the game himself. He's got to be somewhat of a father figure, somewhat of a dictator. He has to gain the players' respect, and he has to convince them at all times that he really knows what he's doing.
Another way to say it, a college football coach must be a motivator, organizer, educator, and innovator.
We had a couple of changes where you could call it an innovation, like the wishbone. We'd gone through 3-6-4 seasons, and then we tie our first ball game and lose our second, and things are not looking good. Now, we needed a win desperately. The wishbone really did have a great advantage when it first came out, because we didn't know what we were doing exactly, running the offense, but they were going to hit.
Okay.
This strange formation, just people getting rested.
Watching this, recording this.
We struggled in and won our third game.
I don't think so.
Carried on to a 30-game win streak.
I think I'm done.
All you're gonna get 60 minutes today. But it's memories that will last a lifetime.
You have to take a look in that mirror today, because for us to win today, you're gonna have to play your best game. Everybody's got to rise to the occasion.
It comes from the heart. It comes from unbelievable effort. This is where you step across the line into manhood. Playing in games like this.
Thank you. are getting back. But what the Tigers there is to money. Vessel goes all the way, 62 yards on a real
cover. Looks as if Blue Jack is trying it again, so off his head.
Performances by both teams, with the great Blanchard and Davis hitting that. And every pass to more for the touchdown.
Thank you. very hard to describe what it's like to be on the sidelines of a big football game. Football is a complete commitment, physically as well as emotionally and mentally.
And for a coach to be able to see an 18-year-old kid graduate when he's 22 and to see how he has grown during the time that you've been with him, that to me has been the lasting reward.
A lot of things that it requires to be a successful person, you have to do to play football. I must be willing to sacrifice. I must be unselfish. I must put team ahead of myself. I must be disciplined. I must care for my fellow man. I think one of the big things you learn is in football, you're not going to win them all. And so you're going to get whipped. You're going to get beat. You're going to get downtrodden, you know? But you've got to come back.
Those relationships that are built, those live on and on and on. And those are the things that you'll be proud of for the rest of your life.
His growing up might have been in Brooklyn somewhere, and mine right by Cottonville in Mississippi, but there's a bond there as a college football player that's very special.
Football at the college level is played in an educational environment. It's where young people are maturing, growing, learning, preparing themselves to live their lives in the world. I'd say that's what I would encourage people to think about and remember.
I want him to be a better man for having played the game.
Thank you.